Let us have here the last topics on the introduction to algebra, and then next is the linear equation. So we have here useful products of two simple factors. A number of standards results are well worth remembering for the products of simple factors of the form a plus b and a minus b. So these are these ones, a plus b squared, your a minus b squared, and the difference of your two squares, which is a minus b and a plus b. So if we are going to expand this one, that is also equal to a plus b multiplied by a plus b. So that is also equal to, if we are going to multiply that one, that is a times a squared plus a times b, that is ab, plus a times b, that is ab still, plus b times b, that is positive b squared. So that is all over. If we are going to sum those up, that is plus ab plus b squared. Okay, so that is also equal to a squared plus 2ab plus b squared. Okay, next, if we have here your a minus b squared, that is also equal to a minus b, and that is multiplied by a minus b. Or that is, if we are going to multiply that, that is a times a, that is a squared minus ab, a times b minus ab, plus, since that is negative times negative, that is positive b squared. Okay, so that is also equal to a squared minus 2ab plus b squared. So your a minus b squared there is also equal to a squared minus 2ab plus b squared. Okay, next, for this one, a minus b multiplied by a minus b, the result for this one is the difference of two squares. So we prove that one, that if we are going to multiply that one, a plus b, a squared minus ab plus ab minus b squared. So that is all over a squared. We are going to cancel that one. That will become a squared minus b squared. So that is the difference of two squares. Now that is a squared minus b squared. Okay, so for example, this one, a squared plus 10x plus 25, that is also equal to this one. It is like a squared plus 2ab, that is also equal to a plus b squared. Okay, so x squared plus 10x plus 25 is equal also to x plus 5 multiplied by x plus 5. So that is also equal to x plus 5 squared. For if we are going to multiply the last there, and that is also equal to 25. 5 times 5 is 25, and if we are going to add that one, that is the second term for the equation, that is also 10. It is 5 plus 5, that is 10, that is the second term. And for the third term, for the constant, that is 25. Okay, moving on to this. For this one, it is like a squared minus 2ab plus b squared, and that is a minus b squared. Okay, so for this one, it is just like 2a minus 3 squared. Since if we are going to multiply this one, 2a minus 3 multiplied by 2a minus 3, that is 4a squared minus 6a minus 6a plus 9. That is also equal to 4a squared minus 12a plus 9. Okay, moving on to this. Factorization of a quadratic expression if a is equal to 1. Okay, so for this one, it is just like writing again, that is x plus 3 multiplied by x plus 2, since the factors of 6 are 3 and 2. So if we are going to multiply this one, that is 6, that is the last term, and if we are going to add that up, that is also equal to 5. So that is the middle term for that one. So that is also equal to x plus 3 multiplied by x plus 2. And if we are going to get the values of x there, since there are two roots for that, because it is in x squared, so it means there it has two roots for that one. Okay, so if we are going to do this, that is x plus 3 is equal to 0, and that is x plus 2 is equal to 0. And the roots are, of course, x is equal to negative 3 and x is equal to negative 2. And for your example number 2, let's have this one. What is the factors of 20? Isn't it that the factors of 20 is 10 and 2? What else? That is 5 and 2. 5 and 4. Yes, that is 5 and 4. So if we are going to multiply this one, that is 20. Yes, that is true. But if we are going to add this, that is just 12. So it is not the middle term. So for this one, if we multiply that one, that is 20. And if we are going to add that one, that is 5 plus 4, that is 9. So this is a perfect factor for 20, since we got the middle term for that one. So that is x, that is minus 5 multiplied by x minus 4. Since if we are going to multiply those ones, that is negative 5x minus 4, that is x squared minus 5x. Minus 4 times x, that is minus 4x. Plus 5 times 4, that is 20. That is positive 20, okay? So that is x squared minus 9x plus 20. So it is the same. So if we are going to get the roots for that, let us just equate that one to 0, okay? So that is x minus 5 is equal to 0, and x is equal to 5. And for the second one, that is x minus 4 is equal to 0, and that is x is equal to positive 4. And the roots are 5 and 4, okay? So next, we have here x squared plus 3x. So what are the factors of 10? That is 5 times 2, what else? So that is 10 times 1. So if we are going to get the, if we are going to multiply this one, yes, that is 10. But if we are going to add that one, that is 7. But if we are going to subtract it, that is 3. Okay, so if we are going to multiply this one, that is, yes, 10. But if we are going to add, that is 11. And if we are going to subtract that is 9. So the perfect factor for this one is 5 and 2. So if the factor of that is x, that is plus 5, and that is multiplied by x minus 2. Is equal to 0. Since if we are going to multiply that is x plus 5, and that is x minus 2, that is x squared plus 5x minus 2x minus 10. Okay, so that is x squared, and then positive 5x minus 2x, copy the sign of the bigger number there, that is positive 3x minus 10. It is the same with our equation. So if we are going to get the roots, let us just equate it to 0. That is x plus 5 is equal to 0, and that is x minus 2 is equal to 0. So the roots are x is equal to negative 5 and x is equal to 2. There are two roots for the equation, okay? Okay, next is this one, factorization of a quadratic expression a squared plus bx plus c when a there is not equal to 1. So for this one, let us just have an example for this one, that is 6x squared plus 11x, and that is 3. So let us denote this one, this coefficient as a, now the 11 as B and 3 as C. So if we are going to check that one, let us just check A times C. So that is equal to 6 times 3. So that is equal to 18. And the factors, of course, factors of 18 are, that is 1 and 18, 1 times 18, or that is 2 times 9, and that is 3 and 6. So if we are going to add those, no, that is 1 plus 18. 1 plus 18, that is also equal to 19. That is not the answer for B. So your B there supposed to be is 11. So for the second one, that is 2 plus 9. So that is already 11. That is the perfect factor for the equation. So rewriting your equation, it will give us 6x squared plus 2x plus 9x plus 3 is equal to 0. And since 2x plus 9x is also equal to 11x, okay? So we just factor this one, that is 6x squared plus 9x, that's supposed to be 2. 6x squared plus 9x plus 2x plus 3. Let us just combine this one and this one. Okay, so factoring this out, that is 3x multiplied by 2x plus 3 plus 1 times 2x plus 3, because it is the same if we are going to multiply this. Okay, that is 1 times 2x, that is 2x plus 3 times 1, that is also equal to 3. Okay, so if we continue that one, let us just copy this one. No? Let us combine this one to this. And for this one, this is taken as 1 since they are the same. Okay, so that is 3x plus 1 and 2x plus 3. So those are the factors of 6x squared plus 11x plus 3. And if we are going to get the roots for that, there are two roots for that because of x squared, that is the highest power, that is 2. So that is equal to 0. So equating that to 0, let us get the roots for that. 3x plus 1 is equal to 0, and that is 2x plus 3 is equal to 0. Getting the roots, that is x is equal to transposing that at the right side of your equation, that is negative 1 over 3. And next for this one, x is equal to negative 3 over 2. So the roots are negative 1/3 and negative 3/2. Okay, so moving on to example number 2. If we have here this one, this is supposed to be 3x squared minus 14x plus 8. Okay, so if we are going to check this, that is 8 times C, that is just 3 times 8, that is equal to 24. And the factors of 24 are, of course, 6 and 4, since 6 times 4 is 24, and of course, 12 times 2. But if we are going to add this, that is 10, and for this one, that is 14. So it satisfied our equation, which is negative 14x, and we are to separate that. It is the same, that is 12x and 2x. So we have separated that one. Okay, so rewriting that one, it will give us 3x squared minus 12x. Let us join this one, let us combine. Okay, minus, that is 2x minus 8, since negative times 2x, that is negative 2x. Negative times negative 8, that is positive 8. So we satisfied our original equation. And since we can factor this out, that is the common factors are 3 and x, so that is x minus 4. Okay, so minus, we factor this one, that is common multiple is 2, that is x minus 4, that is equal to 0. Since, okay, sorry, that is also equal to 0. So since we have the same here, we take that as 1. So we combine 3x and negative 2. So the factors are 3x minus 2, and that is x minus 4 is equal to 0. So that is the factors of your quadratic equation. No? So for this one, if we are going to get the roots of that, let us just equate it to 0, and we get that the value of your x, and that is 3x minus 2 is equal to 0, and x minus 4 is equal to 0. So for this one, that is x is equal to, transposing that, that will become 2/3. Okay, so for this one, that is x is equal to 4. So the roots are 2/3 and 4. For some quadratic equations, they are not capable of being written as the product of simple factors. That is, factors where all the coefficients are integers. So, to save time and effort, a quick test can be applied before the previous routine is put into action. So, we have here the b squared minus 4ac. If you want that to, that is derived, you know, in your module. So if you want to check it out, check the derivation of that one. So if we are going to check this, if it is a, if we can factor this out, no, if we can factor that, let us check that one. B squared minus 4ac. Your a there is this one, the coefficient of 3 of x squared, which is 3, and then for b that is negative 4, and for c that is, of course, 5. Okay, so substituting the values, that is equal to your b squared there is 4 squared minus 4 times 3, okay, the coefficients multiplied by the constant, which is 5. So calculating that one, it will give us 4 squared minus 4 times 3 times 5, that is also equal to negative 44. So we cannot factor this because it is not a perfect square. So perfect square means if we are going to take the root of that, there is no root for negative 44. So we cannot factor that. Okay, so for this one, 2x squared plus 5x minus 3, if we are going to check that one, using b squared minus 4ac, that is equal to, your b squared there is 5 squared minus 4 multiplied by 2 multiplied by negative 3. So if we are going to calculate that, that is 5 squared minus 4 times 2 times negative 3, that is 49. And the square root of 49 is, of course, equal to 7. So we can factor this equation. Okay?